What's going on, guys? My name is Yankee and welcome back to another video today. Now in today's video we're gonna be talking about the brand new reveal of DLC number 4 Salvation here in Call of Duty Black Ops 3. This is gonna be the final DLC map pack here in Black Ops 3, so a lot of people are getting very excited. Now you guys see in the title of today's video it says Call of Duty then versus Call of Duty now. I just want to throw a picture on screen right now. Guys, take a look at this map. This is actually gonna be a multiplayer map called Micro here in DLC number 4, which just makes me think a lot of people are really gonna be hating on this for the fact that Call of Duty, this is not Call of Duty anymore. I mean, you guys all remember the old, like, you're playing on, like, these trenches, we're playing in older style maps, and now we're playing with hamburgers, pineapples, and cupcakes on a map. This just looks absolutely crazy. It looks really fun to play on. I'm really excited to play this map, but I know a lot of people are just talking on Twitter recently saying, what is Call of Duty doing? What are they thinking putting cheeseburgers and putting a picnic table and iced tea and mustard ketchup in on a map as props? That just doesn't make any sense. Guys, I think this is absolutely unique and really cool. I'm really excited for this map pack. This map pack does come out on September 6th, which is about like 2 weeks from now, so it's coming out very fast as well. So I'm really excited about that, and it's going to be playable at COD XP, so I'll be getting my hands on that very early. So I'm really excited about that. So stay tuned to the channel, guys. In this next week, I'll be talking to you guys about all the information, whether it's Infinite Warfare's multiplayer, this DLC number 4, and also COD 4 Remastered as well. I'm going to be playing all that, so stay tuned. I'm going to be talking to you guys about how all these multiplayer maps are and how the multiplayer is in Infinite Warfare as well. It's going to be a lot of fun, but let's go in and talk about all 4 of these multiplayer maps. We're going to start off with Micro. You guys already saw the picture of it with the cheeseburger and the cupcakes, and it says, what's better than a barbecue on a hot summer day? A miniaturized war zone that takes place on a well-stocked family picnic table. Navigate this bite-sized battlefield for a larger-than-life experience, which just looks absolutely cool. It's basically going to be a picnic table. That's a huge picnic table that we're going to be running on, I guess, something like that. It looks really cool. I'm really excited, but this next map is going to be called Citadel, I guess you can call it, or Citadel. I hope I'm saying that right. And it says, once home to a powerful medieval army, this ancient castle now sits broken and abandoned. Tight corners force close quarter engagements, while the moat and drawbridge allow for a unique player movement opportunities in this mid-sized map. The last trespassers did not make it out alive. Maybe you'll have a better shot. So this kind of, it looks a little weird, because you know how Call of Duty Black Ops 3 is so futuristic, and now we're kind of like going back in time on this map, where it's gonna be like a medieval map. It's gonna be like really old and ancient. So I don't know, it's gonna look a little weird playing it, because you're gonna have all these futuristic guns, futuristic movements in the game, and then you're gonna be on like an old style map. It kind of looks a little weird, but this next map is the one that I'm very excited about. I actually called this 2 or 3 months ago when I was talking about what maps I want to see in future DLC. I said I really want to see Standoff, because I absolutely love the map Standoff from Black Ops 2, and that's gonna be coming back now. It's gonna be called Outlaw, and it basically says, gear up for a showdown in Outlaw, a western style reimagining of the fan favorite map Standoff from Black Ops 2. This is a rough and tough medium sized map that brings classic engagement, flaking routes, and strategic positions for a long and medium range combat. So that's really cool. Again, another like old school map that's gonna be like kind of like ancient, not really ancient, but like more of not really as futuristic as we're used to seeing here in Black Ops 3. But this next and final map is gonna be another reskin. It's gonna be from the map Outskirts in Call of Duty World at War, and it says, this is reimagined as a high-tech facility designed by a futuristic society desperate to repair the Earth's atmosphere. So those are gonna be the 4 multiplayer maps. I'm not really gonna talk about zombies too much, because I'm not really a zombies player. I don't really post zombies on my channel, but I'm sure if you guys want to see that, there's other videos on YouTube that are going to be talking more about zombies. But let me know what you guys think about the 4th and final DLC map pack here in Call of Duty Black Ops 3. I'm super excited about this. Unfortunately, I won't be able to get my hands on it on September 6th and get gameplay for you guys, because I'll still be in Los Angeles at the time, but I will be making videos before the fact talking about how the maps are, how I like them. Are they good maps? Are they bad maps? I'll let you guys know all that information before the maps even release. It's going to be a lot of fun, so hopefully you guys are excited about that. Let me know in the comments down below, guys. Are you excited about this? And really, guys, stay tuned to the channel for this next week. I'm going to be giving you all the information on this 4th DLC map pack, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare's multiplayer, and everything else that we're going to be doing at COD XP, which starts in less than a week, guys. I'm so excited. Thank you all so much for watching, though. If you guys did enjoy the video, be sure to drop a like. I'll catch you all next time. Have a good day, guys. Peace out. Come on.